this is my state of nature story. So I don't want to. No. Do I have to try the disgusting, the bad fish that looks salty with breadcrumbs and disgusting. I hate this. Try it, Mom said. No. I said. Mom said back. If you try it, you can get ice cream of whatever flavor you want. That will not work. I said. You know that. Your bedtime tonight is. You know what? Your bedtime tonight for the rest of the week is 8 o'clock. Mom said. I mumbled to myself, I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of nowhere, like in Europe. Thankfully, it was Friday. I think it was the same time for Saturday and Sunday. It is 6:45 right now. So 1 hour and 15 minutes till I have to be in bed and either watching TV, about to fall asleep, or already asleep. I finished dinner, then did homework. And that time, when I finished homework, it was 7:45. I started to yawn. I fell asleep at the dinner table. I was very tired. It was a long day. Then I woke up because of the loud sounds from my mom doing dishes. 15 minutes. I had to get my pajamas on. 15 minutes. I had to get my pajamas on, my teeth brushed, and be showered in 15 minutes time. I looked at the clock. 7:51. Actually, 9 minutes. Luckily, I'm very fast at showering. I got in the shower and then I got out. I looked at the time. 7:55. 5 minutes until I get in trouble. I got my pajamas on in 2 minutes. 7:57. I brushed my teeth and spit. Then that took me 4 minutes. 8:01. I was in trouble for being late to bed. Why do I have to try everything on the table for dinner? I hate that girl. I hate it. Ugh. I wish that wasn't a rule in my house. I turned my TV on and started to watch TV. Then my mom said, "Lights out." I replied back, "No." Then she said, "Excuse me, either TV off or the TV is mine for 2 weeks. It's your choice, to me or to sleep." I turned it off. I didn't want to lose my TV next. Dad came in. I said to myself very quietly, "Oh great, this can't get any worse with Dad here." My dad said, "What?" I responded, "Nothing, I didn't say anything about you." He said, "Good night, sleep tight, don't let the bed bugs bite you, or else." I said, "Or else what?" He replied, "Or else you'll get a bump where the bed bug bites you. "Oh, good to know," I said. When he left, he closed my door about halfway, but couldn't see me, so I turned on my TV. Then I stared at the TV for 3 hours until 11 p.m. At 11 p.m., I turned the TV off, and then I started to fall asleep. I was asleep. There's no waking me up now that I have fell asleep. It was now boring. I was now eating breakfast and getting dressed for school. I was riding in the car to go to school when me and my mom pulled up in the circle drive. It was completely empty. There was no one here. I got out and I went into school. I got to the classroom. There was only 5 other people there. They were Luke, Ryan, Hassanane, Lucas, and Nick. I wondered, is it winter break or spring break? Then I remembered, no. I remembered it was the middle of February. I said to the janitor, why is no one here today at school? The janitor replied, school these days are optional. If you want to go to school, you can. You don't want to, you don't have to. I said excitedly, "Really? I can leave now?" The janitor said, "No," meanly, "no. Once you are at school for the day, you have to stay at school for the day." I say back, So let me get this straight. There are no teachers, and no teachers here. Not a single principal. We can do whatever we want. The janitor says back. Not 100% sure. Sure. I started sprinting down the hall, yelling yes, and nothing. I need to learn for any subject at school. I had a million thoughts in my head. Right now, sleep, play on the iPads and computers, ruin everything in the school, steal everything in the cafeteria. I was running, and I stopped, and I thought to myself, why would I do this? I sat in my classroom with my backpack at my feet, and I started to feel my stomach. I said, ooh, me hungry, stomach hurt, me go grab snack. Everyone there was deciding when to go out to recess. We decided now. When we went out to recess to play football, I asked, can I play football? They immediately said no. So then I walked away from them and looked back at them. I was sobbing and I was very sad. I said to myself, what happened to include everyone at recess for whatever game you're playing? I started to cry. I was so mad that they didn't want me to play. I walked back over. I said, I can be ref. I'll make the calls equal, please. The people playing football said back, fine, you can be referee. No bad calls. I replied back, I'll try my best to be referee for your football game. Inside, I was so happy I get to be referee at recess. I was making good calls at the beginning of the game, and suddenly I just kept making bad calls over and over. The players started to complain that the calls were horrible. Then one of the players said to me, leave. You are the worst referee ever in the whole world. I thought to myself, I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of Europe. In the middle of nowhere, like in Europe, I think. So I dropped my flag and called the last flag and then left. I said, unsportsmanlike conduct on the offense, still third down. Third and gate, all the way down by the back of the field. I just ran away after that call and I went inside, just waited for the other kids to come in. Later I left school. I went to hockey practice, hoping this could go well. I started the drill and started skating. The person behind me caught up to me, it was almost beating me, but I got in front of him. When I was finished the drill, I stopped and the person looked at me. The coach said, do it again. So we did it. And the same thing happened. I almost got passed, but I didn't. My coach said one hard lap. I went flying. I was approaching the first turn and pow, I went face first into boards. I was down on the ice. I felt like I was hurt, but I wasn't. Then I left when practice was done. I was going to dinner now. I ordered a cheeseburger with french fries. My sister ordered mac and cheese, and mac and cheese doesn't come with french fries. My mom ordered some weird sandwich that looks good in the picture, but really there was lots of disgusting things like pickles, onions, red onions, Swiss cheese, and the most disgusting thing ever, asparagus. So the waitress brought us our food, and before I touched my food, my sister stole all my french fries. I give me my french fries, I said. She replied, you are not going to eat all your french fries. I said, give me some french fries. I was so mad. I thought to myself, I'm going to build a house in the middle of Europe. So now no one was at school. They kicked me out of football. I got checked from behind and now don't have any french fries to eat with my burger. This was a bad day for my life. I thought maybe this should be a record-setting bad day. I thought maybe this day could get... I thought... I thought, could this day get any worse? I was starting to do my homework. Then I got up and got to get myself a Gatorade. My mom had to shred some documents, and she grabbed my homework and ripped it in half, then put it into the shredder. I got back to the table and looked for my homework. It was gone, shredded into pieces. I got really angry. My mom said, "Look, I shredded your homework. Now you don't have any homework." I said, "How will I get smarter if I don't have any homework to do?" Then I thought to myself, "I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of nowhere, like in Europe." I also thought to myself, "What world am I living in?" I woke up, and it was morning. It was very bright outside. I said to myself, "Why did I say I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of nowhere like in Europe in my dream? I would never say I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of nowhere like in Europe. The world would be crazy if there were no rules in the world. I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of nowhere like in Europe. I think I'm going to build a house in the middle of nowhere like in Europe. It doesn't ring a bell. Thankfully, it was just a dream." Thanks for watching. Bye.